We'd like to, at this time, show you one of the labs here at the research center.
Was it 1970 or 1971 that you won the Adler Prize for our medical research, Doctor?
It was 1971. Dr. Pryor tends to be very modest when it comes to discussing his achievements.
Listen, that's all well and wonderful, but true recognition, if it comes at all, should come from persons cured and not from one's peer group. This way, please, gentlemen.
Charlie McCall is in room one.
Oh, Charlie's here. Fantastic. Thank you, Betty. Oh, Charlie, this is a big improvement. You're doing real well. You keep up the arm exercises and come back in about 2 weeks, okay? All right, buddy. Hello, Linda.
Hiya, Doc.
Why is it you will not let the nurse give you your vitamin shots?
Aw, man, she uses a square needle.
But don't you get tired of coming in here and having me stick needles in you?
Well, your needle's the only needle ever stuck in my ass, I tell you that much.
Inhale, please. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. You're recovering quite nicely from your bout with hepatitis. Lie down, please. Now, I don't want to sound like I'm preaching, but obviously, prostitution is not the healthiest job to have. You have pain there. Not to mention what it does for you psychologically.
Oh, the good doctor again, trying to save my soul.
You know, you are intelligent and beautiful, and there's so many things you can do.
You mean like a maid in some tacky hotel cleaning toilets? Thanks, but no thanks. I like what I'm doing.
That's such a cop-out.
Oh, what do you know about it, Mr. Big Shot Doctor? You're the cop-out. The only time you're ever around black people's when you're down here clearing your conscience.
No, nigga, please.
You know that white coat really suits you. Because you don't know nothing about the ghetto. I mean, you dress white, you think white. You probably even drive a white car. And you know what? If I was white, I just might have a chance.
Now, do you feel better?
Well, listen, just don't judge me, because you don't know what it's like out there turning tricks, trying to put food on the table and pay the rent.
I'm sorry. Please step down, I'll give you your shot.
What the hell? Not your fault. I know you mean well, Doc. See you next week, huh? If you ever need a little company, you can always find me at the Moonlight Lounge. Hi.
Hi, baby.
What are you doing here so late?
Well, I have some notes to record from the library, so here I am.
Well, even a doctor could use some fun at night.
Hmm.
I could use some food.
Well, if you must know, I have this very heavy thing going with a guinea pig in the lab.
Oh, I knew it was another woman.
You hurt?
Yes. So, no food. Do you want me to stay here and help you?
I don't think so. You may as well go home. It's okay.
Home? Home to my lonely little apartment.
Oh, baby.
Okay. You promise me you won't work so hard.
I promise you I won't work too hard.
Okay.
I'll call you later.
Call me later.
Yeah. September 15, 11:27 p.m. Subject: experiments concerning the retardation of extreme cases of cirrhosis of the liver.
Good heavens, Henry. Are you trying to work yourself to death?
Hmm. What time is it?
It's 7:35. You've been here all night.
I have? Hmm. Oh, damn.
Looks like they had a free fall, huh? Look, I hope it isn't too bad, whatever it is.
Yeah, that's just it. I don't know what it is. I mean, you cannot conduct research falling asleep.
Now, look, don't blame yourself. Look, I gotta go. I gotta go pick up some samples. You'll be at the meeting.
Yeah, yeah.
Tests conducted on laboratory animals have proved inconclusive. Need human reaction to serum to determine side effects over and above liver restoration.
A dozen rabbits, guinea pigs, rats. Chemistry's not right. Chemistry's not right. I need a human factor.
Emily Johnson, what do you want her?
Johnson, see.
Yeah, she's in pretty bad shape, too. The nursing home just took her and put her up on the shelf and left her there. Hmm.
No family, friends, no one to notify?
No, nobody's even listed on the records in the nursing home, either.
Okay, I'll check into it. Put her in 7B. I'll call Dr. Pride and see if he'll take a look at her.
Yeah, well, I doubt if she even makes it through the night. Come on, let's go.
Hello, research, Dr. Worth. Oh, yes, okay. There's a liver patient in 7B you ought to see about. It's pretty bad.
This could be a good chance to try out that serum.
No, you can't try that serum on a human. That's not right.
That's not right, huh? What's right? What is right? To stand around and watch somebody die while trying to save them? Is that right? So my mother died, you remember that? People standing around doing nothing.
What's going on here? Hey, you all right? Hey, what happened?
I don't know. Oh, good Lord, look!
Billy, do me a favor and check on the patient in 7B and see how she's doing. Would you please?
Hello, this is Dr. Worth. Would you check on Emily Harris in 7B, please? Thank you. Oh, yes. Well, send the records to Dr. Pride right away, please. Thank you. Patient in 7B died. Nurse said something strange happened. She'll put it in the report.
Oh, damn. 5 years of work and nothing?
5 years, 10 years, Henry, what difference does it make? We can't stop now.
I tried to save her, Billy.
I know.
I really did.
I know.
If she were not so near death, I would never have used the serum.
And you did use the serum on that lady.
Yeah.
Well, Henry, maybe the serum was too strong for her heart.
I don't think so. I don't. See, the problem is I don't know when I'm going to get another human patient.
Thank you. Check this dude, man. What is this?
Hey, man.
That dude down here?
Shit.
Looks like he's about to pay us a little visit. Hey, Pop, you're on the wrong side of town.
Can you tell me where the Moonlight Lounge is?
Hear that? This Rudy Poop wants to know where the Moonlight Lounge is. The dude is really looking for a little piece of coon tang.
Right.
Understand what you know about that.
But you're not going to tell me?
What is this? You better move your ass out of here fast if you know what's good for you.
Hear what the man said?
On the corner. You can't miss it.
I'm not kidding you, Linda. Honestly, God, that sucker asked me to move in with him.
Yeah, well, what about his wife?
That's what I said. And he said, don't worry about that doll. I tell her you're the new live-in maid.
A live-in, huh?
I'm the distinguished pimp, Preston. Mm-hmm.
Preston. Shit, that dude don't never let up on my ass.
Is he still asking you to join his fucking Abbey Rent harem?
Girl, you better believe it.
I hear he's got some good connections uptown.
Yeah, well, I don't care what he's got. When I quit tricking for Silky, I promised myself that I wasn't working for no goddamn man again. What I make, I'm gonna keep.
Oh, well, here's to Hooker's Lib, lady.
Besides, someday I'm getting out of this racket.
Well, what you gonna do, hon?
I don't know, but there's gotta be something better than this.
Uh-oh, here comes your ex-boss. I gotta run. I'll see you later, sweetie.
Okay, Gwen, take it easy.
Splitting already, Gwen, baby?
I gotta call my mama, motherfucker.
Yeah, well, when you see her, tell her she know where to send the money.
Oh, man, you're gonna take her tonight.
You got it?
I got what, Silky?
Damn, I'm...
Well, don't play no shit with me. You got my shit.
Yeah, I got it. I got it. Let's be stepping into my office here. We talk some business.
Papa. How's the foxiest lady at the bar?
Bullshit. Look, Silky, just lay off before you get started, okay?
Oh, what's the matter?
I said I was through with you. Now fuck off.
Ooh, I heard that.
Listen, nobody talks to Silky like that.
Let go of me, Silky.
And nobody walks out on Silky.
I said let go of me.
Me now.
I said, get away from me.
Linda.
Hey, man, you heard the lady.
She said she don't know.
So I'm outside of the club.
Hey, you see a white dude come charging through here?
I ain't seen nobody tonight.
Shit. Did you find him?
No, just this dude.
Well, keep looking. He had to come this way. He must be hiding.
You a fine-looking chick. I think I'll take a chance. That's a whole lot of ass packed in those pants.
Just look at you, fool, juicing at the lips. If you knew what I had, baby, you turned back over flip.
Outside and play.
Mama, you're looking
good. I said move. Aw, Gurney, they can watch it. They can wait until we get our stick. You must have the patience of Joe to put up with us the way you do.
You and those kids are my family. Closest I've ever had to one, anyway. When Gus died, it really got tough for us. I worry about them. Suppose something happened to me.
Bernie, ain't nothing gonna happen to you, so quit worrying about nothing.
Linda, forgive me for keeping you waiting. I didn't mean to do that.
No sweat, Doc. I'm not exactly a paying customer, you know. Hey, what happened to your hand?
Oh, it's nothing at all. Please turn around.
Mmm, you smell nice. A doctor that wears aftershave lotion to work. I like that.
That's called bedside manner. I learned that in med school. There you are. You know, you must be taking very good care of yourself because your lab test came out negative. That's very good news.
Hey, I don't mess around with my liver. I take my pills, watch my diet, and sleep till noon.
How about dinner tonight?
Are you serious?
Yes.
Am I for dessert?
No, it's not like that at all. We'll talk, get to know each other, we'll talk about you. Call it, fatherly advice. And there'll be no hanky-panky.
Hanky-panky's my business, Tom.
But not tonight. You're off duty.
Okay, it's the date.
About, 7 o'clock?
Sound set.
Okay.
Oh, Doc.
Yeah?
You don't know where I live.
Well, that's why we doctors have these records.
It's a phony.
You see, you are a wicked woman.
Here
you go. Very
about
well.
7?
Good.
Bye now.
Bye.
Oh, excuse me, Doc.
Yes?
Listen, nurse, I gotta get some vitamin pills for Jimmy.
Well, what's the problem?
I ain't got no money for no vitamins. This here baby ain't gonna never get well.
No, don't you worry about that.
What am I gonna do? I ain't got nothing but some food stamps.
Tell you what you do now. Next week, when you bring him in, you stop at the desk and you answer me personally. Will you do that for me?
Yes.
Okay.
Bless you, Doctor. Bless you.
Okay, bye-bye. Bless
you. Hey, Doc.
Yeah?
I'll order something cheap tonight to make up for that tune.
You were not supposed to see that. You see, that is the father image in me.
Oh, is that so?
Yeah.
Okay.
Billy, you're still here?
Obviously.
Uh-oh. I recognize that tone.
You used that old lady as a guinea pig, didn't you? We could have lost everything.
Look, I took an oath to save lives, and sometimes that oath itself makes it very difficult.
Henry, I love you. But I found some of that serum missing again this morning.
So you're accusing me?
Yes. Look, I know how important this project is to you, but if we get involved in anything illegal, it's going to ruin us.
Don't worry about me, okay, Billy? I'm all right.
You haven't heard a word I said, have you? I mean, you don't even hear me.
Hey, Jimmy. Ah! Good throw. Okay, catch now. Catch. Very good. Very good. Girl, you ought to see the stuff.
Oh, I'm dying to see him.
Oops.
Ow! Well, Kathy, here comes my doctor. Oh, my God. Oh. Good morning. Wait, I can get a good close, but I want to get a good look. Come on. Hey, BMJ, how's it going down?
Song to the song that I got to know now. Hiya, Doc. I want you to meet my best friend, Bernice Watts, and her two live wires, Kathy and Jimmy.
You either. You don't look like Mom's Willie to me.
I would mind you making a house call on me myself, Doc.
All right, Bernie, lay off.
Can I go with Linda?
Not this time, honey.
Can I?
No, no, no. You guys have your own party, okay? See you later.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Doing their thing on 35th Day. Small hood.
Oh, did you? You want to that ass made me want to do something. That's the mother image in me. She tight, she bite. Better give a nigga the green light.
My games are being played. How's it going down? Song till it's gone, that I got to know now. Wish you with me, you were. Nigga try to get me enough. Just cause hunters wanna give me the bug. But type of games are being played. How's it going down? It's on till it's gone, that I got to know now. Wish you with me, you were. Absolutely delicious.
I'm very glad you enjoyed it.
You know, I could get used to this very easily.
Not so important.
It is if you've never had it.
I got a surprise for you.
Surprise? What kind?
Well, you got to come to my house.
Oh, I get it. You get the check and I pay the bill.
Well, you got to get up off of something.
Okay.
I'm just kidding. Come on. It's not like that. You know that.
Well, what the hell? It was worth it.
You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. So I don't know for what. Wow. Is this where you live?
Well, my mother used to live here.
Your mother?
Yeah. I guess I should say she used to work here a long time ago.
Really? What kind of work?
She was a maid. This was at one time, believe it or not, a very high-class whorehouse.
Well, what do you know about that?
When I was a boy, my mother would take me up the back steps. We lived in a room in the back. She would leave me there while she would go out and clean up the filth and change the bed sheets and empty the trash and clean the toilets and look after those ladies of the evening. My mother worked much too hard, and she was very lonely. She drank a lot. And she developed this liver condition. One evening, she was fixing us dinner. She turned to me to say something. And she just fell over. I didn't know what to do. So I ran out in the hall and I started knocking on all the doors. And I was screaming. Somebody got to help my mama. Somebody got to help my mama. And not one of those ladies opened the door. She just died.
You must have loved her very much.
Yeah.
Always, my
Italian restaurants better.
I like soul food myself.
Oh, you see?
I love the paintings.
Thank you. I have been collecting about, 20 years.
Uh-huh.
I think I'll have a drink. So please sit down and
okay.
Make yourself at home.
Hey, now what about that surprise you had?
Listen, Linda, what would you say if I told you that I have discovered a serum that has the capability of curing you permanently? You would not have to come to the free clinic again. Do you know what I'm saying?
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm very serious. It is not yet perfected. It is still somewhat experimental. But I have great faith and confidence that this serum can totally regenerate damaged liver tissues and cells.
Just what do you mean by somewhat experimental?
Well, there are some side effects that I'm not yet sure of.
Now, wait, Doc. Let me get it straight. You want to use me for some type of human guinea pig, is that it? No, thanks.
Just think how this can help other people.
Well, frankly, Doc, I never quite pictured myself as the Florence Nightingale type. So just forget it, okay?
What if I insist?
I said forget it, Doc. Would you take me home now, please? What are you doing with that?
Won't hurt. Listen.
Now look, Doc. I'll make a deal with you.
Deal?
And you... Well, now you try that serum on yourself first. And then I'll do it, okay?
Okay. I'll shoot myself first. Just to show you there's nothing to be afraid of. Nothing. Okay? Nothing to it.
What have you done to yourself?
And now, you must try.
Stay away from me.
In a moment, you look like me.
Horrible.
Look at my hands. Look at my face.
They're horrible!
You know what I know. You feel what I feel.
Miss, are you hurt?
Please, help me!
Look, just lie back and relax. I'll call for some help.
Control, control, this is Security One. Come in, please. Lady, come back! Come back!
Find out who she was.
Yeah. She was Sally Lewis. Lived in the complex. She was a hooker.
Boyfriends, husbands, suspects?
In the black community, Harry, nobody knows nothing, nobody sees nothing, and nobody hears nothing.
Well, somebody really did a job on her, didn't they?
Yeah. That's what bothers me.
What do you mean?
Well, you know, if it had been the regular bit, like a murder, stabbing, shooting, beating, then we could understand it and have the proclivity to solve it. But this little lady has had her neck crushed, like in a vice, meaning somebody has put some shit into the game. Know what I mean, man?
Things don't pick up. I'm gonna go home and climb into the old workbench by myself.
Oh, girl, what do you expect for a Tuesday night?
Let's go up to Hollywood. I understand that's where the action is.
No, that's where all the fags is. Girl, if one of them got up there and found out you wasn't in drag, they'd die. That's right. Things are bound to pick up over the weekend anyway.
Hope so, because I'm running short on bread, and I'm horny, too. Fuck it. I'm going home. Okay.
See you later.
Sure, I know this isn't the usual type of ghetto murder. Of course it's some kind of nut, but what? Sure. All right, I'll get back to you, okay?
Child ass sucking.
Yeah, George, what's going down? The alley. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, thanks, man. Yeah.
Hey, where you been, man? I mean, downtown's on our ass like stink on shit, man. What did you find out?
Got a fucking psycho on our hands. They found another hooker strangled in the alley. That's two hookers killed in the same way in the past 3 days.
So what are you trying to tell me, man?
I'm trying to tell you we got a man who thinks he's a citizen helping us clean up the community.
So in other words, we got a facsimile of Jack the Ripper here, huh?
Oh, boy, sometimes you really use your head, you know that?
Have the patrols in that area increased to a 1-to-5 ratio.
That's a fucking good idea. And the coroner's report said there was a mighty strong dude who killed those two broads.
Powerful dude, huh?
Right.
We better get our ass in the wing, Harry. Downtown wants some answers, and we're gonna have to deliver.
Linda, baby, you got to do this with me. It'll only take a couple of hours. I mean, you know, two dudes in town for the night. Need a couple of ladies out at the hotel by the airport. Now, do this for Silky.
Silky, honey, you mighty pretty. But you still a creep. Now, I told you I ain't tricking for you no more, so just get off it. This lady's in business for herself.
Hey, Linda. This phone call for you. Hey. It's a trick, baby.
I'll be right there.
I won't be needing you. Brenda here is going to take your place, Mama.
Now, you're not talking about Miss No Class. How are you? Because if you are, those guys at the airport hotel are going to throw you out.
Run out! Run out!
Who are you calling, bitch, ho?
Break it up and cut the bullshit, huh?
Cool it, ladies. Like I said, the pigs are here. Oh, excuse me, officer. I meant the police.
You better get to stepping while you still can. Understand, poop butt? Now, we want to ask a few questions.
Don't like questions around here.
Listen, brother, you tell us what we want to know, and we won't hassle you. Now, Sissy Hubbard and Sarah Lewis used to hang out here, right?
So what if they did?
Okay, so we just want some information from some people who knew them.
No, we don't know nothing, sir.
The fuck is the matter with you, man? Two of your own kind brutally strangled, you won't help us.
Oh, Jesus Christ, I don't understand you. No kidding. What the fuck is the matter with him?
It's cool. I'll take care of it.
You fucking asshole!
Just cool it. We'll handle it. We'll take care of it. Brother man, this situation is rapidly becoming insalubrious, meaning we're about to stomp a mud hole in your ass.
Hey, wait a minute. Now, I'll tell y'all anything I can. Sissy was a friend of mine, okay?
Okay, miss. Anything you can say might be helpful. I'll deal with you later.
In the South, slightly, but Sissy was more my kind.
When was the last time you saw her?
Last night, before she left
me. Oh? What time was that?
Oh, a little after midnight. I told her to be careful, but she didn't seem to be afraid. And Sissy didn't have an enemy in the world.
How about Sally Lewis?
Well, she never got close to anybody that I know. She'd come in two or three nights a week, go home with anybody, had a couple of bucks.
Well, she had a couple of kids.
I didn't know that.
Well, has anybody new come in here, any strangers?
You don't get too many strangers. Wait.
Yes? No, it's nothing.
Well,
if you think of anything else, miss, would you please give us a call? Here's my card.
Sorry, I wasn't much help.
Cooperated, that's what's important.
Yeah, thanks. I think we better hit it, Harry. We've got to cover as many of these joints as we possibly can tonight.
Thank you, miss.
You know, can't help thinking I've seen that young lady someplace before.
Probably the lineup.
We did it!
Okay. No, I'm fine. Okay. Bye-bye.
Let me have a little one of that.
Oh, good.
Hey, wait a minute. Here, hold on to that.
Okay.
I think it went out.
Oh,
yeah, a little bit for the mummy. Yeah. All right, a little bit for the mummy in the back. All right, and let's see there, old Silky got Tam Tam home in one piece. All right. That's enough. You got to have food stamps for more. It tastes like chocolate.
Because I am sweet.
Oh.
I'm getting up front.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah. Bye-bye.
Oh, why don't we...
Yeah! Good job!
This is no nightmare, Dr. Pride. You're real. And it's too late to change.
Henry? Henry?
Yes, baby?
Are you all right?
Yeah, sure. Why?
For the last few days, you've been acting kind of weird.
Weird?
Yeah, when's the last time you had a checkup?
Listen, I said I feel fine. I don't need a checkup. Come on.
Oh, I didn't mean to pry.
I'm sorry.
That's all right.
I've been acting crazy, right?
Yeah.
You got away for a few days or something.
Well, my parents still have that cabin up in Bear Mountain. We can go there anytime we want to.
The cabin in Bear Mountain?
Yes.
I remember that cabin.
I gotta go. I'll see you later.
All right. Billy, take care. Pride speaking.
Henry, it's Linda.
How you doing?
Just fine, thanks. Henry, I've got to see you. It's very important.
Okay.
Can you meet me at about 6 at the Watts Towers?
I can be there. See you then.
Okay.
Yes, fine.
Bye-bye. Bye. I guess.
I was very surprised that you called me, but I was glad because I felt that, maybe I didn't apologize right or enough or whatever, but I'm sorry about the other night. I'm sorry.
I never thought it could be possible.
What could be possible?
That after this past week, you can just sit there talking like nothing happened. It's unreal. Doc, I want you to give yourself up. I know you're the one that's been doing all the killings. Doc, you need help. And if you don't give yourself up, I'll have to go to the police myself.
Linda.
Doc, how could you do it to yourself, Doc?
I couldn't help myself. There's this thing buried inside me that won't die. I mean, I can't make it go away. I despise them all for letting my mother die. All of them. But you were right. I could not believe it was not your fault. I guess I've been living my life in a fog or something.
Doc, you've made it. But you're letting a war rage inside you. You know, I thought I was in love with you at first. But you made it quite clear that I was only a patient. Thanks for not playing with me, Doc. I don't know what kind of man you are now. But I know you need help before you hurt somebody else. Well, I better get back.
Get back to what? The same life you've been living?
What else do I know?
I'm sorry you said that. I can't help myself. And I will not let you turn me in.
Well, go on home, Harry, and get yourself some sleep.
Yeah, I would if the phone would stop ringing. Nobody would knock at the door. Yeah, who is it?
Excuse me, Lieutenant.
Yeah, what do you want?
There's a girl outside. She says she's got some information.
Send her in. You go ahead on home, Harry, and I'll check the story out for
you. Why are you in this racket? Because I'm curious. Don't want to stay.
Root yourself.
Lieutenant O'Connor.
Come in. Well, I remember you from the club the other night. Well, what can we do for you, Miss...
Monty. Linda Monty.
Linda Monty. Oh, please, sit down.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, what is it?
I know who the killer is.
What makes you so sure?
I just left him. I told him if he didn't turn himself in, I would.
Okay, who is it?
His name is Henry Pride. Dr. Henry Pride.
Just what makes you so sure?
Oh, believe me, Lieutenant. He's the killer. And I just might get killed for telling you this.
Okay. You're gonna check out this cock and bull story about a black doctor that turns white at night, huh? Let me tell you something, you're gonna get us demoted, you know that?
Well, maybe so, Harry, but I'm gonna check it out anyway. You go on home and I'll call you later.
I'd just like to know what makes you so damn confident that it's true.
Well, read this.
Okay. So she reads the paper about this black doctor and she concocts this fantasy. The black doctor turns white at night, huh?
Well, like I said, I'm gonna check it out anyway, Harry. You going home.
Dr. Wirth, the university told me I could find you here. I'm Lieutenant Jackson, homicide. I'd like to ask you a few questions concerning Dr. Henry Pride.
What happened? Is something...
Oh, no, there's nothing wrong or anything like that, you see. I just want to get some information.
Oh, thank heavens.
Do you know Linda Monty?
I know that she's one of Henry's patients at the free clinic.
Well, do you know of any reason why she might want to harm him?
No. Henry often makes the mistake of getting personally involved with his patients, but... Well, you see, Lieutenant, he's not just a very important man. He's also very kind.
I've read the stories in the papers. Dr. Wirth, I understand you and Dr. Pride are doing some extensive research in the area of biochemistry.
Yes.
May I ask you a few questions concerning that?
Well, I'm afraid that's very confidential at this time. I couldn't tell you anything more.
Bernice, is that you?
Yeah, honey. You got a minute?
Sure. Come on in. Just getting ready for work.
Linda, baby, you're not going out tonight, are you?
I'm saying, why shouldn't I?
With that madman loose about? I don't take to you going down to that place by yourself. It ain't safe.
Hey, don't worry about me. I almost forgot.
What's this?
Jimmy's birthday's coming up. Get him something nice for me.
Oh, Linda, you're darling. This is gonna make him a very happy birthday.
I'm glad.
Linda. When are you gonna get a man of your own and settle down?
I almost did once.
Hey, I gotta get.
I'm late already. Give Jimmy a kiss for me, okay?
Okay. Night, girl.
See you later.
Linda. Linda, get in the car.
Come here. Come back, you little damn it.
Yeah. I almost got to sleep this time.
Well, judging from the suspect's description, I figured you'd want to be in on the bust, Harry.
Really tore up the apartment, huh?
I think we're dealing with a haint, man.
What the fuck is a haint?
That's a cross between the abominable snowman and Willie the werewolf.
Haint. Fuck ever heard of a haint?
Get every available unit to get their ass here as soon as possible. We're going to need them.
Right.
And get the dogs.
Don't kill a dog, Harry.
Look, that's a couple of sharpshooters. Where's the fucking bullhorn?
Pick up a Dr. Wirth at UCLA Research and get her here on a double.
Got between the two buildings. Get the whole area surrounded. He's got a hostage. Now get going.
Surround him, but don't shoot. I don't want any needless bloodshed. And keep those fucking people back!
Chopper to the south side.
Roger, Lieutenant. We've got him spotted. We're on the way in right now.
Side.
I'll give it a go anyway. starboard side, Lieutenant. Listen, I'm going to try it from another direction.
Illuminati, all through your body. The blow's like a 12-gauge shot. Feel me? And God said he should send his one begotten son to lead the wild into the ways of the man. Follow me. Eat my flesh, flesh of my flesh. Come with me. Hail Mary, run quick, see. What do we have here now? Killer, but don't push me. Revenge is like the sweetest joy next to getting pussy. Picture paragraphs unloaded, wise words being quoted. Beat the weakness in the rap game and sold it. Bow down, pray to God, hoping that he's listening. Seeing niggas coming for me, my diamonds when they glistening. Now pay attention, best man, please, father. I'm a ghost, if he's killing fields, Hail Mary, catch me. If I go, let's go deep inside the solitary mind of a madman. Screams in the dark, evil lurks, enemies see me flee. Activate my hate, let it break till the flame. Set trip, empty out my clip, never stop to aim. Some say the game is all corrupted, fucked in this shit. Stuck, niggas is lucky if we bust out this shit. And plus, mama told me never stop until I bust a nut. Fuck the world if they can't adjust. It's just this way, oh Hail Mary. Come with me, Hail Mary, nigga, run quick, see. What you be having now? Do you wanna ride or die? Back with promise makers, never realized the precious time that bitch niggas is wasting. Institutionalized, I live my life a product made to crumble. Once you hardened for a smile, way too crazy to be humble. We ballin', catch me, father, please, cause I'm ballin' in the liquor store.
That's a huge bitch.
to take the man's poontang. Don't miss Ghetto Freaks. Ghetto Freaks is a mother of a film. They try to stop it, censor it, water it down, but it didn't happen, baby. The man lost. Ghetto Freaks comes on strong and tells it it is. A ghetto commune where color can stop the freaks from doing their weird, shocking initiation rites night after night. They were wild, free, and beautiful, and they all did the weird bidding of a black leader. He took the man's woman and made them all sisters, and they kept begging for more. A sweet, funky black chick is all he wanted, but a freaked-out white chick in a daishiki blew his mind. This is where it's happening, baby, in the main city, and the main thing is getting your thing on, no matter what. Do it. Ghetto Freaks makes you want to do it right now. Ghetto Freaks isn't a film about how to show the man your ass, but what to do with his. Groupies, long hairs, and Jesus freaks all under one roof, and they raised hell. And when the going got rough and the bread short, they put the chicks on the street and brought all their money to the leader, the head freak. He was a saint to this family of freaked-out, sex-starved white chicks, and he showed them how to get their kicks where their cracker lovers left off. Shake it, fake it, but make it, baby, do your thing, and make the man think you're doing his. They were busted, beaten, and taken downtown, and that's where the black chicks made you proud you're black. Then they busted out of Harlem and set the city on a freaked-out, sex-starved weekend that ended in blood, crime, and murder. Ghetto Freaks is the picture that explodes on the screen with the shocking, brutal facts of taking over a white commune and turning all the brothers into black sex saviors. If you want to see a film that will make you come alive when you step out on the street, a film that makes every sensuous part of you react with a new sensation, don't miss Ghetto Freaks. See Ghetto Freaks and feast your eyes on some of the grooviest, out-of-sight commune chicks and their sex-starved commune brothers. Every society chick wanted to join his family just to get in on the integrated action. Blue-eyed devils didn't mess with this brother's thing, or they'd find their ass hung high and waving in the goddamn breeze. That's right, baby. They didn't let anything stop them in the man's take from the blacks and use for their white asses' world. Don't miss Ghetto Freaks coming to this theater with full approval of the Third World Ghetto Freaks.